us, Sri Vinod Kakde, Director, Development Monitoring and Evaluation Office. So can you tell us about your insights and experience at the Inno Metro 2024 fourth edition?
Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to represent my organization at Inno Metro. This has been a very wonderful experience and event which I am attending for the second time. Last year also I attended this event, and I have enriched my experience by interacting with many vendors, and also we get a lot of inputs from the vendors, manufacturers, big companies, consultants, which give us input in making the policies for the Indian government.
So, okay, you gave a presentation on trends and challenges in railway sustainability. Challenges in railway sustainability. Can you give a brief description about your presentation?
Yes. So, the topic given to me was sustainability and trends in Indian railways. So, in Niti Aayog, we are working on 13 different sectors, out of which 9 is dedicated to infrastructure sector and 4 towards the social sector. And in these 9 infrastructure sector, one of the sector which gets prominence is Indian Railway. So I have tried to jot down the major focus areas which we have set for Indian Railways in Viksit Bharat, such as green initiatives, okay, sustainable tracks, passengers, inculcation of new technologies which are sustainable in future also. So these are some of the areas which I try to focus on, and I also try to give the snapshot of various milestones which Indian Railways have achieved over the past 10 years, and what is the idea which Niti Aayog feels that Indian Railways should attain in another 10 years or so.
Okay, sir. So can you tell our audience how DMEO is tackling the challenges that are being faced by the Indian Railways and metro sector? So what are those one or two primary challenges that we are facing?
See, one of the major challenge which I feel Indian Railways is facing is high input cost. To maintain the sustainability in terms of environment, in terms of governance, in terms of adopting new technology. The new technology which is coming is not cheap. It is a costly technology. Secondly is Indian Railway is running on the older system. Many parts of Indian Railways which are being phased out are very difficult to get integrated with the new technology. This is also one of the challenge which Indian Railway is facing. And also one of the challenge which I feel is the training of the employees on the new technologies. See, there is always resistance in the employees who are very comfortable while working with the older technology. So migrating them into a new technology is one of the major challenge which Indian Railway is also facing.
Okay, so can lastly, I would like to ask you to give a special message for all the delegates that are present over here.
Yeah, I think all the delegates have done very wonderful job, and I must congratulate them, especially the support staff, and who is running here and there and managing everything so that everything is on time. And one message I try to give them always is try to bring in more people from different sector, because that helps in bringing in a very, very different set of experience, and there is a cross linkages between different kind of knowledges. So triangulation of knowledge happens through bringing in more people from different sector. So you will see that your mission or your conference gets to a more successful in future.
So in continuation, what you said, like multi-sectors should be...
Multi-sector, like railways also caters to the social sector. It is not only a journey for passengers or revenue generation for the Indian Railways, but it is also catering to the social cause. There is... It reduces the journey of the people. The journey of the people should become safer and comfortable. So Indian Railway is doing a lot of... Indian Railway's responsibility increases many folds. So that's why I feel that you have to bring in people from different sector also to learn and gain from their experiences.
Sir, I would like to also touch upon the topic that you said, that employees and people are generally much used to the older methods.
Right.
So is DMEO is working on getting any technical programs that might help people to understand the newer technologies?
Yes, yes, certainly. We do a lot of capacity building programs. We have a lot of partners such as JPAL, BMGF, Bill Gates, Melinda Gates Foundation, World Food Program, and UNDP. So many consultants who work on many aspects of social life, they do the training. So in conjunction with them, we have developed the training programs for state government and public sector units also.
So can you tell us where the people might find these programs? Like, how can they approach this program?
So the people, if they are interested, they can always visit our site, which is www.niti.gov.in and dmu.gov.in. They can always visit our website. They will get to see all the information available regarding the training, capacity building, and our knowledge partners.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for giving us your time.
Thank you. Thank you very much.